Indulge us as we get a taste of the celebrity lifestyle sweetened by Magnum ice cream.
Nikki Novak here for the Young Hollywood Network at the Viper Room. And on this episode of Guest List Only, we're taking you inside for exclusive interviews with Mia Tyler, fashion designer Andrew Hilfiger, and the Click Clack Booms. Mia Tyler. Mia, you're looking gorgeous.
Thank you. I'm a little stressed out.
Are you stressed?
I'm trying to de-stress. This is my de-stressing sitting here.
Well, just sit back and relax and chat. We'll tell you how amazing your photography is. I was having a look at it. There's sort of like a meld between like color, sort of black and white, sort of like muted tones. How did your style sort of evolve?
I just kind of started taking photos. I started taking pictures of like my brother. I think the very first picture I ever took was my brother in the kitchen in his underwear, and people would ask me to take pictures, and so it's kind of evolved that way. And then finally, Nathaniel from the Click Clack Boom was like, you should have an art show, because I have so many pictures.
A lot of your family members are in your pictures, like your dad, Steven Tyler, and your sisters. Do you get your inspiration from people who are closer to you?
I get a lot of inspiration from my little sister, Chelsea. Sometimes there's a storm, and after the storm, we'll go down to the ocean and get driftwood and little pieces of stones, because she's an artist, and I always bring my camera and take photos of her. There's one kind of artsy shot that you kind of can't tell, but it's her at the beach looking in her reflections. And then Jesse, because we're together, he's my boyfriend, and we live together, so
he's adorable.
Yeah, he's my little
choice.
He's my little rock star. He's a handsome boy, so I'm always clicking pictures of him. I'm actually on the road with the band shooting them for Andrew Charles Line, and it's fun. I get to be with my best friends and my boyfriend and take pictures and get paid.
You have a great life.
I'm pretty content right now. I think I lived the last 10 years for everyone else, and I'm finally just doing things for myself. And I always wanted to do photography. I was kind of miserable being a model, and I always wondered what it was like to be on the other side of the lens. And now I get to do that, and I am so happy.
Do you have any sort of like daily indulgences?
And I love just waking up and taking a shower and like washing my hair. I have like my rituals, the things I do, and lotioning and all that kind of stuff. But I wake up every morning, and I wake up next to Jesse, and it's kind of like my favorite time is morning time.
I guess Dad would have to be cool with you dating a rocker, right?
The first time they met was at the Super Bowl, and they both wear their shirts down low, and I think they had like a unbuttoned shirt off, and it was pretty funny. They were just like staring at each other and like figuring out what they were all about, staring into each other's eyes. But they definitely had a shirt off, an unbuttoned shirt off. It was pretty funny.
Who came up with the name?
Excellent. Oh, this guy right over here.
My mom named us.
Really? What was it after?
Birth.
It was right after the birth that he was named.
She heard a click clack boom when you were born?
Yeah.
There's a lot of violent screams, I would imagine. But he came out, we named him Click Clack Boom, and that was it.
Here's father.
I was
now.
There. Yeah, that's right.
So this is your LA debut, playing at the Viper Room. There's so much history here. Do you sort of, like, when you come in, do you sort of feel that energy, or you feed off the energy?
Hey, what's up, you guys?
Yes.
Yes, found.
He really thought about that before he said it. Do you have any like performance rituals? Anything like, are you superstitious? Anything you guys do before you perform?
Superstitious. We hit the Ouija board pretty hard beforehand. Do we go on? Yes. And then we go on. And that's it.
What makes you guys stick out?
What makes us stick out? We like to wear cool hats and ridiculous clothing. I got this cool chain. We're kind of outrageous people, I suppose.
What about your music?
It's very eclectic. It's very experimental. Jesse plays a whole whirlwind of instruments, including violin, keyboard, and
Violin's a very unique instrument to have in a rock band and sticks out.
Oh, any crazy LA stories since this is your LA debut?
I definitely was walking around LA doing my thing and saw Christopher Walken this morning wearing full like sweatpants gear, walking not even sideways, defied gravity. I don't know how his like lower half was this way, but his upper half was this way. And I just said, hey, and he said, hey. And that was it.
I think that's the best LA story I've ever heard.
It's pretty good, right? If you add like reverb and post-production to that story, I think it's gonna sound fantastic. And then I saw Christopher Walken this morning wearing full like sweatpants here. And I just said, hey. And he said, hey.
I am here with Andy Hilfiger, the creator of Andrew Charles. Fabulous clothing line. How
are you? Thank you. I'm great.
Do you have a little bit of the Steven Tyler inspiration going on wearing a scarf tonight?
Absolutely. We have a line of rock scarves with Steven Tyler, and they actually sold well. There wasn't enough of them. I'm sure if we had them at the fashion show today, everybody would have wanted. We're doing more, though.
First of all, your brother being Tommy.
Mm-hmm.
And when I think Tommy Hilfiger, I think preppy.
Yeah.
Are you the rebellious brother? Did you always have that sort of rock and roll style?
He really took the classics and defined them. Where I'm taking the rock and roll classics from like the boho chic, 1970s, Anita Pallenberg, Bianca Jagger. It's like the rock star's girlfriend or wife. You know, flowy, very Coachella girl. That's what I'm calling it.
Well, speaking of Coachella, it is Coachella season.
Yes.
Give me some do's and don'ts.
I think people just layers and mixing and matching. So there's not like, nothing's perfect, but it's flowy and fun.
What's happening for spring, summer?
Lots of prints, jungle, Coachella girl, which we're doing a blue and white group that's washed out. Maxi dresses, you can wear them as skirts or you can wear them as halter dresses, wrapped with belts.
You're speaking my language, you realize.
Yeah, well, my wife speaks this language, so that's where I learn a lot of it from.
What is like one of your daily indulgences? How do you indulge yourself?
Today was busy. We had the fashion show and we're having the after party, but you know, I get up, I work out, I go to the office, I do my thing. Maybe go see a band or go to dinner somewhere.
Like an indulgence would be like listening to music.
Oh, definitely. Definitely. That's like a release, a celebration.
And so how did you get involved with the Tyler family?
We needed an iconic rock and roller that had the aesthetic. He was into doing it. I said, how about your daughter, Chelsea? Because she is our girl.
Any fun Steven Tyler stories behind the scenes?
The first night I went to his house for the photo shoot, and he showed me his closet, and it was like...
What's his closet like?
As big as this room, but all like the 70s boho chic rock and roll stuff that we all grew up on. And so he was showing me stuff and I was showing him stuff. I brought four or five trunks of my vintage. I gave him a pair of snakeskin boots that were the Rolling Stones. And he wears them on Idol. Stuff like that.
Can we get invited the next time? Have a little wardrobe session?
Absolutely.
And Young Hollywood come along?
I love Young Hollywood.